idea. We go from Lawrence to Tuscaloosa, where the number one team in the country is trailing Chattanooga right now. Dave Neal and Matt Stinchcomb with the call.
Bama. C.J. Board back to return for the Mocs. Good high kick. Fair catch called for at the 19-yard line, and that is where Alejandro Benefield will throw it to the wide side. Bagley, junior quarterback out of Lovejoy, Georgia. Hands it off to Bagley. He's got some running room. First down to the 35-yard. He'll swing it again to the wide side, and no gain on that play. Will delay handoff. That goes to Crane out of Tampa, Florida. Glad to have those guys here tonight. Benefield try a little quarter. Chattanooga will have to punt it away on fourth down. Wobbly kick that will hit. Well, dangerously close to hitting a Crimson Tide player, but for the Crimson Tide. Hurts lost the football. Does Chattanooga have it? Waiting for a signal. They're jumping around like they have it.
Looked like Dale Warren came in there. Number 20, linebacker for University of Tennessee Chattanooga. Jalen Hurts. Carrying that football a little bit loosely in traffic.
6-yard pickup, and it's second down and four. They will hand it off to Damian Harris. And a flag comes in.
There is no foul for face mask. Third down.
Saw the flag come out. That's a good no call. Well, you see Reynolds, he's got his hands on the jersey right below his face mask.
So now it's third down and two. Hurts around the left side. He'll have the first down at the 36.
See the ball bouncing around right there. See Conte Davis, number 93, on it.
More in here. And they will. Here goes Harris. Cuts it back. He's close to midfield. And the Mocs from Chattanooga up a field goal. Second quarter on the way.
Dave, good news for the Tide for Reuben Foster to come back out running, helmet on, hands freshly taped up. But yesterday, Coach Saban warm up in a knee brace, appeared to move well. They'll evaluate if he gets in tonight.
Thanks, Olivia. Jalen Hurts,
shark teeth, one row after the next coming in. Not the case this season.
Hurts looking for it all. Tight spiral, Ridley open, touchdown Alabama. 47 yards.
And he'll be open for about 20 yards, and it's just whether or not Jalen Hurts feels like his arm's warm enough to get it all the way down the field. It really was just a matter of time. This is something that they've wanted to get going. See Ridley, who's more than capable of getting behind.
Touchdown pass of the season. Adam Griffith with the point
after. Stewart to this world.
Hurts now 6 of 7, 80 yards through the air. Griffith. Or Shady with the return, trying to get to the outside, and he'll be pushed out of bounds as the Mocs trail 7-3. And that play
before
did not
the
work.
Offense does.
Second down and 13. Here's Crane. He's got nowhere to go, and
but their speed alone eats up all the space you generate by kicking and throwing it to the edges.
Those rugby kicks that are hard to return.
But also offensive coordinator Lane Kiffin, his ability to accommodate a true freshman.
Hurts going deep again. This pass a little bit short. Somebody Coach Kiffin was talking to us yesterday about an eye on his future. Here is Hurts trying to get a block on the outside. He'll get it close to midfield.
Then you would otherwise if there was a pass tagged on the other end of these runs.
Boy, that was a broken play. J.K. Scott again to punt it. Boy, that is a power kick that is dropped, and Alabama will have it. They will have it. Oh, his own guy
That's
bumped
exactly
into
right.
him, and Keaton Anderson fell on him.
Exactly right. C.J. Board, he's trying to make the adjustment.
First and goal for Alabama. Hurts trying to run for it. Flipped up in the air.
He got burned on the pass play to Calvin Ridley, but cartwheels Jalen Hurts right there.
Hurts coming left side, hit hard again and again, and he has stopped shot.
By the box defensive front.
All the big boys in now for Alabama. They'll go handoff right up the middle, and Harris is denied. Hurts trying to run for it. He will throw it. Touchdown, Alabama. Garrett can throw.
You see, he wanted Dieter first. He pump fake, though, because you can see Trayvon Brown's right there in the area, making it adventurous after the great field position on the turnover.
Players that are up for those awards: Jonathan Allen, Reuben Foster, Ryan Anderson, Minka Fitzpatrick, O.J. Howard, Hurts, Cam Robinson, to name a few. And a big hit on that kickoff.
Burn a couch if you win.
The Mox at the 20 will hand it off. They'll go inside again to Crane, who bounces off, and he will have the first down to 32.
Great job by Tomlinson for 54, but you see, never really got Crane down. Those are the types of yards.
Winfield rolling left, pass is caught. That is close to the first game at running back. Quick hitter coming near side. James Stovall with the receiver. Pass is caught. Jonathan Allen, so a third down and 8. And that ball is incomplete, coming near side. Trayvon Diggs back to return this kick. It is a line drive that will be fielded on a hop. Diggs out of bounds.
Versus UTC here early.
There's Harris. Spins his way out to the 40-yard line.
Absolutely. He's having to contribute more than I think they anticipated. Offensive backfield.
Isaiah back that time. And here is Hurts. And he has dropped. Hurts looking to throw. Passes, they're going to say caught.
They're at that position on their offensive front.
Bourne will try to chase this one back. All the way around the 5. He breaks a tackle, but then is thrown down.
It's down to 10.
The box. And off by, I love this game. The box. Going to Bagley on the far side.
Got it. They've had a couple of measurements in this game already.
Going to field that quarterback. It's a snap. Hands it off to Bagley. Here's Bagley again. Try to use the stiff arm. That's just not going to work.
Flip the offensive line over to the left side.
Going to field. They'll try to scramble for it. And he'll been here in 2009, came back in 2013, and each time Alabama returned a punt for a touchdown against them. One time it was Arenas, the other time it was Christian. Touchdown. And that run play will only end. I think folks around the country are a little bit surprised by this result after the first 30 minutes of football. 14-3, the number one team.
14-3, probably a little bit disappointed given the special teams mishap.
UTC actually had the football for 6 more minutes than Alabama did in that first half, and they'll start the second half with the possession of the pigskin.
No, but our kids are playing hard and they're excited. I mean, coming out of that locker room, man, I couldn't keep them in there. They were so excited to come back at
first. Rush of the second half. Winfield passes caught. That'll be a first down over the 40 for Prime.
Only just one in the first half from the Mox.
13 of 16 for 100 yards. Here's a little Bagley. Bagley goes 180. Here he comes near side. And he is walloped at about the 40.
Jeff Durden was worried about, because he comes flying downhill when he makes his tackles.
stops already tonight for Alabama. Third down and short. Benefield. Boy, nice little push down and 10. Delay handoff to Crane. Boy, just didn't get over the outstretched hands of Dalvin Thomas. UTC will come near side, and that'll be incomplete. The Baylor school will punt it away. There's that end-over-end line drive kick that will roll out of bounds.
Corn curving back in at right guard for Alabama.
Here's Jalen Hurts on first down, and he will
money drop it over the head of Trevor Wright.
Here's Hurts. He just got nowhere to run.
Oh, but some of it is his decision making.
Yeah, Jacobs has one carry, and that's it. He'll dump it off to Ridley, and he'll have the first
catch for Ridley.
Quick throw to the wide side. Cam Sims got a
passing
couple.
Attack, a big physical receiver for Alabama.
Again, Jalen Hurts.
Boundary, but by then, he was in the grasp.
Now Hurts will just try to run it, and on third down, J.K. Scott punts it away, and another tight spiral. That'll be fielded at the 18 by Board.
Ready one. Does that one? Ready two. Take two.
Take part, please. Thanks.
As those guys call the video board, we'll call the play here, and Benefield will throw like 19 total employees, 12 students, doing a great job. And UTC will call. Boy, short kick that will take a favorable, albeit short, bounce for UTC.
Big Ten championship game, they make it there. Obviously, Penn State, their path is clear as well.
Alabama on.
You're still among the top four teams.
To the near side, Cam Sims makes the catch and falls forward. 4.5 to go here, third quarter. They'll run it with Harris. He'll have the first down and drives to the 25-yard.
Special guy.
He's put together physically and mentally.
Here's the physical side of it. Turns the corner and touchdown, Alabama.
Nice stiff arm on C.J. Fritz. Stays in all the way into the end zone. Tight rushing attack.
Point after. Okay.
It's a similar dynamic. Yeah. See those guys sitting out for any chicken wings anytime soon.
Kick into the end zone. That'll be a touchback.
Seems like Will Peppers does a little bit of everything for Michigan.
Robertson in at quarterback, as we suspected he would be. Bagley.
A loss.
First down and 10, they'll give it off to Derek Crane.
Playoff contention to think about.
Here's Robertson trying to turn the corner. And he will be a couple of yards. State a couple weeks ago in Starkville. So maybe only three teams from the Southern Conference.
Fifth tackle on the year for Reuben Foster.
Colin Brewer with the punt. Another one of those end-over-end kicks that'll be down to the 25-yard.
The ruling on the field of the kick illegally touched is under further review.
They were saying the UTC might have touched the football where it is spotted right now at about the 34-yard line. It was downed around, the 25 there.
I don't know if it came off of Tay Davis's hand. His left hand, just number 19. Yeah. Looks like he glances right off of his glove.
Boy, if our officiating crew spotted that, that is great vision.
You see the ball deviate just a little bit from what would otherwise
be frustrated.
After further review, the ruling on the field of the kick illegally touched is confirmed. The spot was the 39-yard line. First down, Alabama.
Gotcha. This is exactly the reason why. As Jacobs getting a carry, Josh
carry
Jacobs.
Quickness where you don't have to block. He can make his own block and shake you loose.
Here's Hurts. He's got some room to run. Trying to set up his blockers. He kicks it into overdrive and is down to the 20-yard.
Turned into a lead blocker versus a receiver.
Now Jacobs gets past the first defender. Hurts. Lofted up toward the end zone, just out of the reach. They trail 21-3 to top-ranked Alabama. Sound football here against the number one ranked team in America. Jalen Hurts over the middle, and that ball almost intercepted.
He comes running upfield in frustration. You see that football? It's got to come out, and it's just a poorly placed ball. Trevor Wright in coverage, he's beaten. You see him get hit right now, right as he's releasing that football, likely.
3-of-3 last week.
Performance. Coaches were pleased with how their quarterback performed in the passing game. It's a different story so far here tonight.
Well, that ball.
It's a dangerous proposition. Benefield played well in the passing attack. Where you end up almost losing, being taken out of your offensive game plan before you even take the field.
Touches in the ground. Boy, on third and short.
Incredibly difficult to run the football inside.
Brewers, end over end kick taken. Here's Diggs. Flags are down, and he dances his way. What about the 43 yards today?
During the return, illegal block in the back, number 48, return team. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down, timeout.
Just going out here having fun and believing in themselves.
Okay, let's talk about you. Congratulations are in order. You are named one of 26 semifinalists for the Pro Football Hall of Fame.
Depth at all is on that offensive line. Here's Harris.
See, Bama's so nervous that they ran left immediately right behind his backup, and Corin Kervin. Left again. Converted D lineman guard playing your left tackle spot.
Play fake. Hurts. He'll just throw it away. And
the linebacker has somebody in protection. He'll end up blitzing anyway.
Loose football. Dale Warren, I think, came up with the football.
Corin Kervin get up. But watch Jacobs. Leslie comes in. And you see him end up on top of him. And watch Skiante Davis. Again. He almost had a recovery in the first half. And Kervin jumps in there right at the tail end. We saw O.J. Howard in the first half able to wrestle a recovery away from the UTC defense and get it back for Alabama. And Kervin got in there late. See, it looks like he hurt his left shoulder.
Room area. Robertson will throw it out to the wide side. DeJuan McCord.
That's almost a three-alarm fire there.
Not that far, so you're looking at four more games.
Right.
Number one ranked team. And when you consider that he has done it in about half the time. A little different story here tonight. Alabama up 24-3, and they've had a tough time.
UTC has gotten after the Crimson Tide up front.
Here's Harris trying to pick up that lost yardage and then some. He'll get it out to the 29. Chris. Oh, free play here for Alabama. Hurts. Just throw it in, getting a head start.
Offside, number 7 defense. 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay third down.
It's been our Darius Stewart tonight. And we understand he's kind of a healthy scratch. They just haven't played him, but he has suited up. I want to look at this spot, perhaps.
Alabama has called timeout to challenge the spot short of the line to gain.
And I thought Coach Saban was on
it. Replay booth. This is a booth-initiated review.
You see Ridley try to get upfield. Blocked by that SEC logo there, but ball's in his right arm. see there whether or not he has advanced the football.
ESPN.
The ruling on the field stands. Fourth down.
It's inexplicable. I don't understand that one.
Averaging almost 49 yards a punt, and he just, I mean, he knocks the air out of the ball every time he punts it. C.J. Borg. That one's 54. That will be the rematch here in 2016 after what happened today in Baton Rouge.
Showed up big time and controlled that line of scrimmage when they needed to.
And a loose football. It's on the ground, and Alabama says they have it.
A little bit concerned about coming into this game. Read option. Robertson was going to get hit by Anthony Jennings anyway, but it looked like it was just a bad exchange. He and Alex Trotter.
Hard line. They'll work out of the pistol formation. Quick throw. They'll get it to Sims. Boy, he is swarmed. Boy, I tell you what, UTC.
There, you want to see what you hit. Tackle with your face mask.
Hurts throwing toward the end zone. Incomplete. Quick hitter near side. Cam Sims tripped
Williams,
up.
True freshman, right tackle, over at left tackle for this possession.
Hurts to the end zone, wide open. Touchdown, Alabama.
1-3
game here. Florida. And then they will decide their fate for the playoff. Let's head back to the studio. Expected to go, including Citadel, the Southern Conference champs, along with Wofford. It's by brother Bill Oliver, who, of course, played here at Alabama under Bear Bryant, was a defensive coordinator here for the Crimson Tide, also defensive coordinator at Auburn, and was an interim head coach at Auburn.
Pile up. The team was lacking focus.
Handoff goes to Nalls. Let's go down to a little. Trayvon digs to return it. This one will take a favorable UTC roll down to the 22-yard line. Celebrating at 12.
But the injuries, I think, are the biggest and probably most concerning aspect of this football game.
Here's Derek Gore. He cuts it back and bounces off one defender. And
harp on this game. How do you, what's your message after this one?
It depends on the personality of the team. I don't think the guys were being played in this football game. Ardarius Stewart was healthy. We never saw him. Bo Scarborough was available. We never saw him. So it played him a little bit this season. That's not helpful either.
Gore again. But you know this, the team will be Matt Stinchcomb and Olivia Harlan. I'm Dave Neal. So long from Tuscaloosa. Let's head back to the studio.